Now let me give you a brief overview of the subject now, because I think we already covered 40% of this subject, and there's still 60% of the subject which is left. And now it is, I think it is the right time to give you what we are going to study, how we are going to study, and what are the languages, how they are interrelated with each other. Okay, see, first of all, we studied something called as finite automata. This finite automata was of two types. Number one is a deterministic finite automata, and second one is a non-deterministic finite automata. Okay, so here you can say this is the set of deterministic finite automata, and outside it is the set of non-deterministic finite automata. It means to say that every deterministic finite automata is also non-deterministic, but every non-deterministic finite automata is not deterministic. Okay, it does not mean that non-deterministic finite automata is more powerful than deterministic finite automata. Okay, now I told you the languages accepted by finite automata, the languages accepted by finite automata are called as regular languages. Languages accepted by finite automata are called as regular languages, and the languages which are going to generate these regular languages are called as regular grammar, are called as regular grammar, or you can say type 3 grammar or type 3 grammar. Then we studied something called as push down automata. This is noting push down automata. Now again I told you there are two types of push down automata. Number one is a deterministic push down automata, deterministic push down automata, and second one is the non-deterministic pushdown automata. And deterministic pushdown automata, non-deterministic pushdown automata combinedly are called as pushdown automatas, right? So every non-deterministic pushdown automata is not a deterministic pushdown automata. So the languages accepted by pushdown automata, the languages accepted by pushdown automata are called as context-free languages, are called as context-free languages, and the grammars which generate context-free languages are called as context-free grammars, or you can say type 2 grammars, or you can say type 2 grammars. Then there is something called as Turing machine. There is something called as linear bound automata, LBA, and this Turing machine is of two types. The number one is halting Turing machine, and second one is only called as Turing machine, which may halt, may not halt. So this circle is noting linear bound automata. The languages accepted by linear bound automata are called as context free context sensitive languages, and the grammars which generate these context sensitive languages are called as context free grammar. And then we have Turing machine. Then we can have a halting Turing machine. Halting Turing machine is a smaller set than the set of Turing machines. The languages accepted by the Turing machines are called as recursively enumerable languages. And the languages accepted by the halting Turing machine, because it is a smaller set, the languages accepted by the halting Turing machine is called as recursive languages. And the grammar which generate these languages are called as unrestricted grammars. They are called as unrestricted grammars. So unrestricted grammars are called as type 0 grammar, these are called as type 1 grammar, these are called as type 2 grammars, and this is called as type 3 grammars. So we are going to explore this subject, this complete subject, from this point. We initially studied finite automata. Then for the finite automata, we studied regular languages. Then we studied regular grammar. Then we studied representations of regular languages, which is the regular expression. Then we studied what is a pushdown automata. After pushdown automata, we'll be studying what is a context-free language. We already know what is a context-free language. Every language which is accepted by pushdown automata is a context-free language. Then we'll be making a classification for context-free grammars. So this type 3, type 2, type 1, and type 0, this classification is given by Sir Noam Chomsky. So this is also called as Noam Chomsky classification of language grammars. Then we are going to study what is Turing machine. After that, we'll study what is a Hartink Turing machine. Then we'll be studying what is a linear bound automata. Then we'll be studying what is a recursively enumerable language, regular recursive languages, and context sensitive language. This is different and this is different. This is regular, this is regular, and this is recursive languages. And the grammar we generate the recursively enumerable languages are called as unrestricted grammar, are called as unrestricted grammars. Okay, we'll be studying all these things one by one. After that, we are going to study what is the computability and decidability of a function, and then we'll be also be studying the, you know, complexity classes, etc. So as of now, I think this is a rough overview of the subject. So we'll be doing everything in more details. We'll be studying grammars in more details. What are the different operations you can perform on a grammar? For example, how can you minimize a grammar? How can you convert a given grammar to a pushdown automata? Or how can you convert a pushdown automata to a grammar? Or how can you convert a grammar to a finite automata? How can you convert your grammar to a finite automata to a grammar, and so on. There are a lot of subtopics which we'll be covering. So most of the questions which are asked in gate examinations are from finite automatas, countability, decidability, and all these topics only. Turing machine, some questions from Turing machine, some questions from pushdown automata. We'll be seeing that is not a problem. Okay, we'll be seeing some smaller topics also, like some theorems. We have pumping lemma theorem for regular languages. We have pumping lemma theorem for context free languages. We'll be studying that. And we'll be studying a lot of countability and decidability things also. Okay, we'll be studying that, don't worry. So as of now, take this down. So this is a rough overview of the subject, and then we'll move on to the next section. Okay.